Your nerves survived that shaky ride. Yeah, I know, but the quad only fits one. You'll get used to it. So, welcome to Melmoth Forest. I'm sure you'll love it here. Such peace and quiet. Yes, yes, cash is transferred every Friday. Don't worry, we won't forget. I know it's not easy as a newbie, but... The line cuts out sometimes, but I'll be quick. Everything you need should be right on your desk. And I'll fax over the details of your first task now. There's a corkboard in the caravan for your research. Just pin it up there. I'll wait. Okay, you can read back on this if you forget what to do. Now, can you see a small GPS device with an antenna? Your first task is simple. We just want to make sure the equipment works. So, first find the tree I marked on your GPS. Easy. Then place a camera nearby. Yes, exactly, pointing towards the tree. With that done, you can head back to your research caravan. Once you're in position at home, hit record on the recorder and then, well, we wait. When the recording is finished at night, you can review it. As soon as you see the squirrel on your TV, snap a picture, print it out, and fax it to me. Got it? It can take a few days to get used to the work, so don't worry, there's no urgency. You're all set? Great. Then we'll talk again soon. Seems everything works like a charm. So, now what we really need is a close-up of this squirrel near its stash. We found them in treetops, under rocks, buried underground, anywhere, really. When I did this study 15 years ago... Oh, did I forget to mention that? Yeah, believe it or not, Panorama tried the exact same bullshit back in 82, trying to get this damnable dam approved. I know, but they won't succeed now either, thanks to you. Anyway, from my work back then, I know the squirrels here take the same route every night, so I'm sure you can follow him easily enough. When you have the squirrel in frame at the end of the recording, print out a photo and send it over. Oh, and Simon mentioned something about dropping off some extra stuff for you? Maybe check outside. I guess now is as good a time as any to tell you what we're actually doing here. The Viago Institute, the place we work for, performs impact studies. Yes, exactly. Construction companies need to commission studies like this one to be legally permitted to build anything. And this one is commissioned by an entity known as Panorama Corp. They want to build a ludicrous 5-star condo place here called Panorama Land. I know. And they tried something just like this 15 years ago. But my research into native squirrel habitats had to shut that down, because our fluffy little squirrels are classified as an endangered species. So your work here could help to save this space for the squirrels to live in. Anyway, I'm probably boring the ear of you. Let's get back to work. Interesting. Looks like this one doesn't go very far into the forest. But hey, it's the middle of the night. Go to sleep. I'll call you back in the morning. Let's try something a little more challenging. We know that some squirrels build their nests, drays, a little bit further away from their nut stashes. According to my records, this one can go pretty far, so do be prepared for this task to take quite some time. I updated the location on your GPS. Good luck!
Thank you.
Why would a squirrel stash dynamite and matches? I mean, did the squirrel plant that there or who? It's pretty clear that some things have changed since last time I was in Melmoth Forest. We'll have our work cut out for us, getting to the bottom of this.